Hey, is that folk music that you play there? What is that? How do you call that folk music?
I think it was Studs Terkel who asked Big Bill Brunzi, did he consider his blues music to be folk music? And Big Bill says, well, never heard no horse.
Just again.
show is Horses Sing None of It. My name is Ralph Litwin, and our guest today is the Blaire Reinhard Band. This is Blaire behind the keyboards and the set of lungs. How you doing?
I'm doing well. Thanks so much for having us, Ralph.
Our pleasure. And this is a family band, sort of.
Yeah, it is definitely a family band. Gray over here on the keys is my brother.
And, hi, Greg. I've
been playing with him my whole life. I'm the older sister. And Wade here is my husband.
Hey, Wade.
Who I met because Gray and Wade were in a band together in college. So, and Keith is the resident family member.
Hey, Keith. And you also have a famous grandfather.
Yeah, we have a lot of musicians in the family. Most people know our grandfather, Doc Severinsen. We have yet to play with him, but we're hoping to soon. Live, at least.
Do you call him Grandpa Doc?
I do, yeah. Grandpa Doc. To distinguish between, you know, our other grandfather.
Who is actually a doctor.
Who is actually a doctor, yeah.
Cool. Well, what about that first song? What was that called?
That was called Final Farewell, which is the first song that we are recording on our second album. A taste of things to come.
Great. What would you like to play for us next?
We'll play Could It Be, which is the first track off our album, Steps on the Ceiling.
So how does the songwriting work?
Well, I wrote that one while I was shopping, which I keep telling Wade, let me go shopping more often. But we kind of all write on our own and then sometimes together. So you know, it's kind of all over the place. A lot of the songs are, you know, old projects that we've kind of revamped, and some are just brand new. While we were recording the album, we kind of thought of some new ideas, or, you know.
Yeah. We really have every combination possible of writing, as far as combination of people.
Yeah.
So.
Good to keep it.
No method to the logic.
Yeah, not a lot of methodology there.
Good to keep a variety of influences in.
Yeah, which, you know, we're always trying to find out about some new groups to listen to, or, you know, new influences to bring in.
Cool. Yeah. What would you like to play next?
Next we'll play a song called Gutter Bottom Blues. Stuck on you like gum on a table bottom. I'm stuck on you, gum on a table bottom. Won't you stick to me, be my sweet candy cotton? You've grown on me like mold on something rotten. Maybe you've really grown on me. You're molded on something rotten. I'm gonna grow on you. Oh, I'll not be forgotten. For me, I'll meet you at the bottom. Said if you fall for me too, I'll meet you at the bottom. Said if you fall for me too, I'll meet you. Me too, gonna meet you at the bottom.
dig that one.
Oh, good.
So you've had a lot of success placing your songs on television shows.
So far, so good. I hope the luck continues. We've had some songs placed on So You Think You Can Dance on Fox.
That's hot.
That was, I think, maybe the most exciting one. Some soap operas, although I've yet to see the song actually on the show. I used to work on Chappelle's show, and they'd call me in for a couple of compositions here and there. Gray and I wrote the theme to the General Mills breast cancer awareness campaign called Pink Together. That was probably what we were most proud of, I think. It was a really fun project to work on. Just keeping them going.
And you've been on MTV.
Yeah, a brief moment of of MTV stardom. Yeah, we got to be in this quick little scene with Alicia Keys and Nick Lachey, and we got to perform our own song, actually the one that we just played, Gutter Bottom. And it was the weirdest thing because we each had like a line, and we were all fired up to get our one line out, and it was two full days of just sitting at like a booth with Alicia Keys and Nick Lachey and kind of like not knowing what to say to them, you know, because they're huge stars, and we're just sort of like, okay, can't wait to play my song in front of you, Alicia. So it was fun, though. They were really nice.
Cool. We should tell folks how they can get in touch with you and find out more information about your recordings and your touring schedule.
Sure. We have a website, blaireband.com, B-L-A-I-R-E, band.com. And info@blaireband.com is a good way to reach us.
What's next?
Next is a song called Runaway Mind. It's also one of the ones that we're going to be recording soon for our next album.
Satisfy yourself or deny yourself. Go the route that sets you free. No, you can stay yourself or run away yourself. Just don't run away from me. Thank you.
Runaway Mind.
So I want to get the inside scoop on Grandpa Doc.
Inside scoop? He's 82, I think, and he's probably in better shape than all of us. He works out every day, and he still's playing. He said he was retiring a couple years ago, and he's definitely not retiring. Yeah, he's still active with a group he met down in Mexico, which is where he's living now, kind of playing a whole new kind of music, and it's really fantastic. Definitely worth checking out, El Ritmo de la Vida.
Cool.
Yeah.
What would you like to close out with?
We'd like to close out with I Don't Deserve You. It's also off of Steps on the Ceiling. You're the one I've been needing when I'm not strong. And I knew it was wrong. And I keep on searching for more reasons why I can take for granted all that you give me, and you don't seem to mind.
Tell you. should know.